gone solo. Her album is called Diva. It's a word which means a distinguished female singer or a prima donna. So which is she? Annie, welcome to the Ozone. Why did you call the album Diva?
The thing is, it's a slightly ironic title for me because for years and years now I've been quite well known, and I think that because this is my first record and my first statement, I wanted a title that held something of a double meaning for me and the public, as it were. Now, I've chosen that life because I'm a musician, that's what I do, and I love it. But as much as it gives you tremendous opportunities and experiences, it also devalues you as a human being, as a private person.
So Walking on Broken Glass, what's it about?
It isn't really important. It's almost like a sort of joke about the kind of song I normally would have written in the past, lyrically, but now I don't feel so much that way. So it's just kind of almost like a parody of a sort of self-penned song in a way. The character that I'm portraying is meant to have had a dalliance with John Malkovich's character, rather like the Glenn Close character in Dangerous Liaison. And he is now getting married to a beautiful, younger woman, and I am forced to participate in the wedding with my husband, who's played by Hugh Laurie, who's delightfully funny in it.
So do you find it hard to act?
Well, the trouble with me is to get me to tone it down, because I'm such a ham, I'm such a drama queen, that it's very easy for me to act. But, I find it easy to act when I have a vehicle of a song to perform.
So has it been harder to write songs since you split with Dave?
Well, I never found songwriting easy to start with. And for that reason, the balance and the dynamic of a duo partnership was a great thing for me, because where I had weaknesses in my songwriting, Dave had his strengths, and vice versa. And the two of us complemented each other very well, I think.
Because you were so strong together, how did you realise that you were going to have to make the split and go alone?
Well, there's a point when you realise that it's no longer something that's thoroughly enjoyable to you on a personal level. And Dave and I have always had a sort of very rocky relationship, you know? And as well as being incredibly creative. And it had been something that we'd been struggling with for quite a few years, and it just reached a certain point. I think we both understood it. We never discussed it. There were never any grand hysterics or histrionics, you know. It was just a question of, I went away and actually had a baby, and Dave did other things. So it's never been discussed even.
Are you a confident person?
Well, I'm a contradictory character anyhow. I mean, I have a great deal of overconfidence probably in myself and in what I do, and yet at the same time I carry a tremendous amount of self-doubt, and it's almost as if the two aspects of my personality are often at odds with each other. I think that anybody who feels totally comfortable in this world has got to have a sort of lobotomized brain. You know, I mean, everybody must feel alien in some way, because the world is a very dangerous and evil kind of place in many respects. So I think it's a very fine game that we play when we are on this earth, as it were, we find ourselves here. And I just hope that I'll, you know, just become better at it, whatever it is.